In this week's episode, we will learn how to create dependent drop-down lists in simple ways. More specifically, we will learn how you can create a dependent drop-down list of employees when you choose a specific department. For example, I choose finance and I can see only the employees in the finance department. If I choose sales, which has four employees, so I will see four employee names under that. And we will do it in two different scenarios. So one, if you have a horizontal layout of data, another one when you have a vertical layout of data. Now let's get started. So I have a file where all I have is my raw data. I haven't done anything, any formulas yet with it. So let's start with this file. So the first, the horizontal layout, let's say we have a group of departments and then the employees in each of the departments. So what I'm going to first do is to select all of them and then do Control T. And then I would say my table has headers. This would create a table first. And the next step I'm going to do is to create a list of, so a name manager, go to name manager, and then say new, and then this will actually be the headers in this table, and I'm going to call them as L underscore DEP for department, and I'm gonna hit okay. So now I have created a list of departments. So if I want to start preparing, for example, this is where I'm going to do my drop-down lists. So let's say we do this. So here, I'm going to do data validation, and choose list. And here I would press F3 to pull the L underscore DEP. And now we have a drop-down list. So this is great. And now we need to figure out the dependent drop-down list over here. We are going to use the offset function in order to do so. But before we start writing the formula using the offset function, let's just prepare a few things which makes the offset formula easier to understand. So the first thing, I'm going to name this cell, which is the input that the user is going to select. So I underscore DEP, which is going to be the chosen input department. And now the next I want to do is to find the column where the department is found. So I'm going to do match this department name, I underscore DEP, in my list of departments, do an exact match, and it'll tell me the column where we found it. So if it's HR, it's going to be second column. If it's finance, it's going to be the first column, and so on. So now I'm going to name this thing as C underscore column. And the last thing we need is how many employees will be there in the chosen department. So number of employees. So here what I'm going to do is to use a count A function. To the count A function, we need to pass the employees belonging to only the chosen department. And so this is where we're going to do index. And then in the index, we're going to say go to, I think we didn't name the table, but let's just go with table one. Usually I would name these tables, but that's okay for this video. So let's say go to the table. I'm not going to give a row number because I want to pull all the rows, but which column? That is this column. So this results in an array of values, and then the count A, let's close that. That's going to count how many values are there. And the important reason why we want to do this in a function is because sales department has four employees, the other departments have three. We want to make sure that our drop-down list is smart enough to know that. So we are going to store this number of employees in C underscore, let's say EMP, calculated number of employees. So now we are ready to write the formula, which is going to drive the dependent drop-down list, and that's going to use the offset function. And we will type the formula here, and then we will actually copy and paste into the data validation. So we're going to do offset, and we're going to start from the first cell here. So I'm going to write A3, which is the first cell there. And then how many rows should I go down is one, because the first is the header. So we want to go at least one row down and start looking for employee names. And then how many columns should I go? And that's where you'll use the column we already calculated. But keep in mind that we have to do minus one because finance is the first column. But we don't need to offset for finance because we are starting in this. So that's where we would do the minus one. And then let's say, what's the height of the array that we want? And that depends on the number of employees. So I will choose this. And this is the reason why we pre-calculated these two things so that it's easy for the formula, the offset function formula, to be understood. So we go start from A3, we go one row down, and then we go the number of columns minus one, and then we how many employees are there is already calculated, so we'll use that value. So this should result in the list of employees belonging to that specific department. Control Z. So I'm going to copy this formula. I'm going to go here, data validation, list, then paste, and press OK. So now we have a dependent drop-down list, which is only employees belonging to that department, and it'll actually be it'll account for the number of employees in each department being different. That's still fine. And if you want to add more departments, that's also fine. You just add a new column here to say project manager or management. And now this will expand to project management. And then if I type in KLMN, and now the employee list. So let's go project management. Employee list will now be KLMN. So this is how expandable and flexible the solution is. You can expand the number of departments easily. So you can hide this part in your, if you're building a template for others, then this is the end user facing thing. So when you change something in the back end, it'll automatically get pulled in through. So this is how flexible the solution is. You can add more. The only requirement here is that you cannot have blanks in between. So if you have a blank here, then it is going to pull the wrong list because it keeps thinking there are three values and it picks the first three. So make sure that you don't have any blanks in between the columns. You can have blanks at the end, that's okay, like here, but you cannot have blanks in between. So that's one requirement for this method. And now we'll go to the second part, which is to find out if it's in a vertical layout where you have a list of departments and the employees belonging to each department. So I'm going to do something similar. So let's convert it into a table. My table has headers. Okay, so now what we're going to do is similarly, we're going to use the offset function to do so. But let me just prepare first. So let's say we're going to do department and employee again. And I'm going to, just for now, I'm going to keep the same. I'm going to copy here. And this is going to use the same drop-down list as here. I have a separate video which talks about how do you create a distinct list of drop-down values based on a set of input which has repeated occurrences or duplicates. How do you create a drop-down list? So I'll put a link to that video, so I'm not going to cover that part here because the focus of this video is to create a dependent drop-down list in the employee side. So we're going to write a formula in the data validation here. Before we do that, let's similarly calculate a few things. So the first thing is row number. So which row are we finding the specific department? Let me choose, for example, finance. We need this cell to be named first. So I'm going to name this as department two because we already have the other department. So in this case, what we're going to do is find this department match I underscore department two in our list of departments here, table, and find an exact match. So this is going to result in the row number where it finds it. So the first time that happens, it'll be recorded. So HR comes the first time in the fourth row of the table. So it goes and pulls that number four. So now we have this. So now we need to know how many employees are in that department. So this is going to be, again, number of employees. However, this time we don't need to do a complex one. We can just do a simple COUNTIF, and we are going to do COUNTIF in the range, go and find this selection. So it's going to find how many employees are there in that department. So now we have these two things. We are ready to write the formula, which is using the offset function. So we will again start with cell at the beginning. So we will do A10, which is the first cell of the table. And then how many rows should we go down is dependent on this. So if it says four, it'll go four rows down. And then how many columns offset is going to be one. And that's because I think we didn't name this row number here, but you guys get the point. So the row the column would be one, because employee column is one column to the right of the department column. So I'm going to put one. And then what's the height that we want to extract? And that depends on this number of employees. So I'm going to close it and do this. As I said, I usually name them. That would be easier to follow, but this works fine for this. So I'm going to go to the data validation list and do this. Okay. So now HR will have this, and if I choose sales, it'll actually have four employees. And if I choose something where there's nothing there, it's not going to pull up because we don't have any employees entered here in the project management department. So that's why it wouldn't work. But if I go to finance, it'll work. So one requirement here is that this list should be a sorted list, meaning I cannot have finance, HR, and then finance, because the assumption we made when we wrote this formula is the first time we find something, we will select that and then go along until the end of the number of employees in that department. So this requires all the employees in finance to be together, all the employees in HR to be together. If your input data is not like that, you can just go and sort it and then do sort, custom sort, and you would want to do department, and then you can do the employee as well, but that's optional. Sort by department, make sure that it's sorted so that all the employees belonging to one department are together. So that is a requirement if your data input is like this. That covers this week's episode. What we learned today is if you have a list of categories and subcategories, you can create a dependent dropdown list using the offset function, and the formula is slightly different if you have a horizontal layout or a vertical layout. In both cases, you can actually expand the number of categories and subcategories without changing the formula. The formula will automatically grab new values entered in the categories and subcategories, and it will still function. The only two requirements are the horizontal layout, you cannot have blanks in between, and then for the vertical layout, you need to sort them so all the employees in a department are together. I hope this video was helpful. If you found this helpful, please share it with your friends and subscribe to the channel, and I will see you all in the next week's episode of Ask Your Excel Question. Thank you very much for watching.